Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are watching this out there on the World Wide Web. This is Jeremy Gielem for Syscon TV. We're here at 9th Cloud Expo, Cloud Expo Silicon Valley. I have with me Shannon Williams, which means we can catch up on the story of CloudStack and where it's... You realize that CloudStack really owes quite a lot to Cloud Expo. You know all of that.
Well, I've been here since the first day, so I do know a lot. In fact, I was at Cloud Expo at least six, maybe five. Our first time when we visited Cloud Expo, Shed and I were just attendees, and we basically were trying to trap people anywhere we could find them and kind of start talking about this idea we had for CloudStack back in 2008. Yeah. So it would have been one of the first ones out here.
Yeah,
I think the first
really
one.
You are one of the first pioneers.
Yeah, it was early days, but it was a much less impressive location, so I like it here. Better.
So that was a reference to Shen Yang, your CEO, and congratulations on being bought by Citrix. So we now speak to you in your new livery.
Let me tell you about virtual desktops.
It has gone well.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. We're all excited to be part of Citrix. I think it's, you know, when you start a company, you always hope something like this will happen. You'll grow up, be big enough to start to acquire customers, to get real market momentum, and then either really grow like crazy or find a great home like Citrix to foster the technology further.
But it also is a great fit, let's be clear.
It is. I mean, if you look at the Citrix product portfolio, whether it's the Zen Server hypervisor or the NetScaler, you know, networking equipment, or it's, you know, tradition around virtualization of the desktop, you know, Citrix has played a big role in cloud already. It powers many of the biggest clouds, whether it's Amazon or Rackspace. And adding in the orchestration layer, adding in what CloudStack delivers and Cloud Portal and some of the other pieces on top of that, it really helps kind of complete the entire package from a customer perspective.
Well, let's do that. Let's reverse up, you know, back up a little bit. So let's be quite clear. Let's explain to somebody who's, you know, they're thinking CloudStack, OpenStack, OpenShift, my head is spinning.
Sure.
Let's just calm it down and tell them what it is that CloudStack is. And I'm sure that you don't have anything against anybody else. So let's just orient people.
Yeah, sure. So the CloudStack really came out of cloud.com. It was a product that was built from the ground up by our engineering team. We built it back in 2008 to begin with and have been growing it ever since. It's a it's an open source product. It's been available for people to download since literally day one. And now it's, you know, got a large community of about 7,000 contributors. It's used by 200 companies around the world. It powers clouds as big as 20,000 servers. So it's been an amazingly successful open source product, and it's got a lot of momentum behind it.
And what does that mean? What is the future trajectory now that you are part of Citrix? What does that allow you to do? Where does that allow CloudStack to go that maybe mightn't have happened without them?
Well, I mean, the biggest thing is it gives us scale. I mean, as a small company, when we were acquired, we were about 60 people, 70 people. And, you know, my role there was running the sales organization and working with all of our customers in the field. And the difference between a 6,000-person company and a 60-person company in terms of reach and the ability to bring the product to new places is just amazing. I think in the last 4 months since we've been acquired, I've probably logged about 120,000 air miles getting in front of new customers, talking to them about the cloud. People who really, you know, weren't thinking about running their desktops, running their infrastructure on cloud in the cloud before. They were kind of heading down a more traditional route. And all of a sudden now their Citrix rep, who they've been working with maybe 15 years, says, well, you know, we bought this new company. Come look at the CloudStack, see what it does. And it's amazing. I mean, the amount of enthusiasm for this type of technology is just, it's really global now. I mean, you see it I think in the last quarter, we've seen customers in every geography around the world start using the product, start consuming it. I mean, literally from Iceland to South Africa to Egypt to India to Singapore to Canada. It's just everywhere. And that's really been exciting.
And from an engineering standpoint, it keeps developing all the time, even as we're speaking, presumably. That's the joy of the open source side.
It is. I mean, on the one hand, we keep adding to the core engineering team that Cloud.com built and developed. But what's been amazing is that as the product gains maturity, as it gains market share, we start to see real contribution coming back. I mean, really exciting contribution coming back. One of the things we were talking about a lot here was some of the work that the Zenos team has done recently on monitoring. They've built this great monitoring tool using the open source that's, I was recently at one of the world's largest telcos, and they were playing with this monitoring system that Zenos built on top of a CloudStack implementation that they had built themselves without ever talking to Citrix, without ever talking to Zenos, and then kind of bringing us in afterwards and saying, hey, this is really cool. Can you guys help us, you know, take it to the next level, productize it, you know, start to get it ready for prime time? So that's that's what you get from an open source world. And as a startup today, you know, the opportunity that open source gives you to tap into developers, to tap into new ideas, to tap into innovation, and to get a route to market. I mean, it's so hard as a small company to find routes to market that, you know, you can spend $20 million in VC money in a blink and never get the kind of the customer adoption that you will from a really well-run open source community. And that's what CloudStack.org has become. I mean, it just, you know, every month I'm amazed at the new number of signups, the new number of people that are using it, that are consuming. And it's like it's universities, it's students, yeah. It's governments, it's all sorts of places we never would have thought were going to be big customers for cloud computing. But, you know, they absorb it, they use it, and all of a sudden they take it out into their next careers, into their next jobs, and all of a sudden it's in a bank, and it's in a, you know, it's in a telco, or it's in a retailer or a manufacturing company that's using these things to change the way they deliver IT services to their customers. So we're really excited.
Now that CloudStack.org is up and running, has Cloud.com done its work? Can it go on to help some other company get themselves bought? Is it for sale?
Gosh, no, it's definitely not for sale. I mean, I think that the Cloud.com name is, you know, right now it's still very live, very much in use, and we're still using it as a marketing site, talking about all the neat things that the CloudStack community is doing. There's going to be some cool stuff happening with that, I think. Citrix has some great ideas about what Cloud.com will be, and I probably shouldn't unwrap them yet, but a little patience.
Booby trap him there, but he didn't fall for it.
No, it's great. It's one of the classic, you know, one of the classic moves that we made. Peter, I think, can be thanked for that.
He takes credit.
Peter and Kyle, great guys that made a good decision to buy that domain name.
They certainly did.
We helped them do it, so we take some credit as well.
Right.
Thank you so much, Shannon Williams, for joining us here in Silicon Valley. I'm sure we'll catch up with you again in New York. I hope we will, anyway, 7 months' time. Thank you so much, and thank you for joining us out there on the World Wide Web.